tilt your hand up so it's there. You can see the peak rise. Move it around if you think you need to. And see how, I'm not going to move it, see how there's a gap here, and there's no gap there. If I was to tamp on that now, obviously it would be slight, but enough to cause channeling down this side. Yeah. So when I have it here, again, in our specific setup, I just go like that, and it just makes that gap disappear. Yeah, which is, yeah. I then, instead of swinging as such, because that'll push the coffee back to where we started, just to really sort of straight down, if you like, on here, so that the edge of the bench hits that bit just there. Straight down. That's, and you can see we've got a relatively even bit of coffee there to go with. And then half strength first.
So you're angling that quite a lot.
That's the difference.
Okay, so
more or less level.
Yeah. Well done. Mm. Good point. Mm. So half strength first. Have a look at it, see, is that even? Pretty even.
Yeah.
And then I think I saw also, I don't know, can't remember who it was, you don't need to actually necessarily press all that hard. There does need to be a level of strength to it, but it doesn't need to be, you know, all the guts in there. So, and a little twist. I should do that again. I put the pressure on, and then I kind of ease off. I'm still putting pressure on, but I ease off, and then just turn about a quarter of a turn. What that does, it just like seals the bed. And there we are, feeling it. So what we're going to do is get rid of the swiggle, just do a simple heart, which is what I meant to do last time actually.
Awesome,
that
we get
to. Down there, come into the middle, and then you'll see the milk start to come up. And just follow through.
Right.
So the milk's bouncing off the back and coming back at you.
Yes, you did. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, because it finds this one, you know, it's called the box, so
yes.
You put it in, so it's everything.